Hello friends, my name is Harsh Shah and my teammates are Harshad Rathod and Ravina DeCosta. Today we are going to present our capstone project, which is about text classification using deep neural network architectures. Text classification is an important natural language processing task useful for understanding audience sentiments. So if a business is willing to understand how their product is being received in the market, this technique is very useful to understand the tone of millions of reviews all at a go by training a machine to perform this task. We have chosen Amazon Reviews sentiment dataset for analyzing customer reactions on Amazon products. So this is a brief overview of how the dataset looks like. So as you can see, it consists of total 4 million reviews. The format is label and correspondingly it's review. So label 1 basically means it corresponds to a 1 or 2 star rating and it has a negative tone. Label 2 basically means it is a 4 or 5 star rating and it corresponds to a positive tone for the product review. So training set consists of 3.5 million reviews, the validation set of 0.1 million reviews, and the test set is split to 0.4 million reviews. So like any text processing application, the text reviews has to go through some initial processing layers to make it ready for machine learning models to consume it and generate predictions. So these are the set of pre-processing steps that we have implemented, like converting the text to standard UTF-8 format, which is easily readable, removing extra spaces and digits and non-word characters like punctuations, removing URLs as they don't specifically convey any language tone, removal of stop words like is, the, it, etc. Tokenizing the text so that each word is represented by a single numeric token, and padding the total reviews, padding the size of each reviews to make it 100. So while analyzing our dataset, we saw that each of the reviews has different size, like one is of 36 words, one is of 44 words, one is of 60 words. So on an average, the maximum that we found was like 85 to 86 words. And so we have chosen a padding size of 100, which covers the entire review. So the choice was made consciously after analyzing the data. The next step is a major step, which is converting each of this tokenized word into a vector representation. So major step of converting these tokenized words into vector representation is done using pre-trained GloVe word embeddings. So this is provided by Stanford NLP group. So we have used GloVe 6B100D file for generating the embeddings. So the file is trained on a large corpus of text data like Wikipedia. And what it generates is each word similar to generates a 100 dimensional representation of each word with its similarity value to other different words in the entire corpus. So this serves as a good initialization of weights in neural network rather than choosing any random initial weights. And we have demonstrated this in the CNN code file too, which I'll walk through later. So we have basically tested this on three different neural network architectures, like convolutional neural network, recurrent neural network, and hierarchical attention networks, to compare their performance and choose the best model. So the first one that I'll be going through to now is convolutional neural networks. So this slide basically explains the architecture of the CNN model using a visual graph of the model. So once the embedding matrix, that is a basically you can consider embedding matrix as a map which has the key as the original word and the value as the vector representation of the word that we have got from the word GloVe word embeddings. So once that is generated, the next step is to replace each of the input word with corresponding word vectors from the embedding matrix and train the neural network. So this task is accomplished by the embedding layer of the neural network. Along with this, it also defines the input and output sequences, like size of input and output sequences at each layer. So in our case, both are 100, like the input is all input to the embedding layer is 100 and the output is also 100. Since we, as I initially went through, we have padded each of the reviews to make its size as 100. And also since we have used GloVe embeddings of 100D, So it gives each word is represented as a vector of as a vector of size 100, which represents its similarity with all other words in 100 dimension. So this layer is followed by the dropout layer and the batch normalization layer. These layers basically ensure that the model does not overfit the training data. Dropout layer specifically makes some of the neuron values in the layer as zero to achieve this task at each training epoch. These layers are followed by a sequence of convolution layers where we have used filter of size 32 and with depth of 3 and 7, varying depths. This filter size of 32 was chosen after like experimenting with different kind of filters with size 18, with size 128, etc. And we found that 32 fitted best for our data set. The batch normalization layer, which follows each of the convolution layer, helps in normalizing of the input at each training phase. Like the dropout layer works at each training epoch, and the batch normalization layer works at each training phase, like after each convolution is performed. To this helps in avoid overfitting within each epoch. The next two layers are the global average pooling layer and the softmax activation function layer, which is used at the output layer to give us two class probabilities, whether the like the probabilities of the review belonging to the positive class or the negative class. And accordingly, we'll assign the review to the positive class or negative class based on the highest class probability value. Now I'll briefly walk you through to the code and explain each of these steps. So we have used Google Colab for our implementation. These are just sample output that we have shown to make you understand that this is how the initial review appeared in the training set with the label and the reviews. And after performing a set of pre-processing operation and separating the reviews and the labels, this is how the new data look like. These are the set of five reviews which we have displayed to make you understand this. So we have stored the output of each of the pre-processing phase as pickle files so that we can load it directly during our test phase, like training and test phase, and with minimum amount of time. So this analysis basically shows you that we have equal set of positive and negative reviews, and that is why there is no skewness of data, and this will help the neural network model to fit better on both the positive and negative tone reviews. We have used Keras for our implementation, and this is basically the model architecture that I explained to you via the visual graph. We have trained our model on different set of inputs. Like we have trained it on 0.6 million reviews, then we have trained it on 1 million reviews to see what is the impact on corresponding accuracy. And this I'll explain you through a table later. Now, as I explained during the pre-processing phase, that how did we decide, like, do we want to use pre-trained word embeddings and what are the hyperparameters we set for it? So using pre-trained word embeddings with trainable parameter equal to 2, that is the weight will be dynamically modified as the model is trained on the input data. We achieve the highest accuracy as opposed to not using a word embedding or using with embedding what using word embedding but trainable equal to false. So we have used this as our setup for the neural network model. So after the training phase, these are the set of accuracy and loss plots that we get. So the loss is continuously decreasing after each epoch, and the accuracy, as you can see, at the end of 5 epochs, we have achieved around 92% accuracy, which can further be improved by increasing the data set or the number of epochs. Then we have used this model that was trained. Like we have loaded it again for testing. Like if you can see, this is the code that loads it from the Google Drive, and we have used it to test on our test data set, and we achieve a similar accuracy of around 91.7%. So this ensures that there is no like overfitting, as we are achieving around the equal accuracy for our validation and testing data sets. Now next we'll go, as I told you, we have tried different data sets and different number of epochs. So this is the summary table of it. Like we use the entire training set, and we achieved 92.7% accuracy with one epoch. And For with five epochs with a reduced data set, we achieved ni around 92% accuracy, which shows that the more amount data you give, the better the model is trained, and also the more the number of epochs, the better the model is trained until it overfits, which currently it's not. So next we'll move on to the RNN.
RNN. We have implemented the RNN using three LSTM layers with 80 units in each layer, followed by a dense layer of size 2 and softmax function as the activation function. We have tried out several architecture and found out this architecture to be the best among our choices. For activation layer, we had two choices, softmax and sigmoid. Results were similar with both the activation functions, so we choose softmax function arbitrarily. Since we are classifying sentences into two types, that is positive and negative, we are using categorical cross entropy as a loss function. This makes sure that our prediction are not biased towards one class. Let us go through some code. We have data set of 4 million reviews. However, we are going to use only 1 million due to space and time limitation. We have built the RNN model with the architecture explained earlier, and we have used 900 million thousand reviews for train set and 100,000 reviews for validation set. Initially, our validation accuracy was more than the training accuracy, showing the signs of overfitting. So we have increased the dropout rate to tackle the overfitting problem. We have already predefined a number of epochs to be 5 for comparison purpose with the other models. However, increasing the number of the epochs will increase the accuracy. Our training accuracy was 89% on train set and around 90% on validation sets, which shows that there is a scope for improvement. We tested our model with the 4,000 reviews as a test data set and found out that the accuracy was around 90%.
Hello friend, this is the architecture for the HAN implementation, hierarchical attention networks. The data of the train and the test set needs to be processed in a format that mimics the hierarchical structure of a document. To maintain uniformity, we need to specify the maximum number of sentences per review and the maximum number of words per sentence. We have set these to 6 and 42 respectively after taking the averages on the entire training data set. Our data is a three-dimensional in nature. That is, the words form sentences and sentences form reviews. We need a time-distributed dense layer to apply the same dense operations on every time step in our 3D tensor. In this case, we need to apply the same operations to each and every word. That is why we have two time-distributed dense layers, one before the bidirectional GRU layer and the other before the attention layer. This vectorized representation is further used to generate annotations for each word using the bidirectional GRU layer, which computes the annotation of a word from both forward as well as the backward passes. These word annotations are now used to generate weights signifying the importance of the word in a sentence using a multi-layer perceptron. The weights are trained using the custom attention layer. Finally, we get the sentence vector as a weighted sum of all the words present in it. This process is repeated on a sentence level. Sentence vectors are used to generate annotations using the GRU, and attention layer is used to generate weights. Finally, the weighted sum of the sentence vector gives us the document vector, which can be used for classification. Now, I will walk you through the code. So this is our code. As you can see, we have imported the required libraries. For running any training or testing code, you need to load the embedding matrix and the word index matrix. This is the code for preparing the subset of the data. Here we have computed the averages. And this is the code for the hierarchical structure of the training data. Here is the code for loading the training data and its corresponding labels. Here is our implementation of the attention layer. And here's the model architecture. As you can see, there are two phases. One is the word level attention model and the other is the sentence level attention model. We have trained our model on 5 epochs and we have used checkpoints in order to ensure only the best model is stored. You can load the model and its history using this code block and use it to generate loss curves and accuracy curves. As you can see, the training loss is decreasing substantially and the validation loss decreases as well. The accuracy increases as the number of epochs increase. Specifically, the training accuracy increases steeply and the validation accuracy increases fairly good as well. Now, this is the code for preparing the data for the test set. As mentioned before, we have already prepared this data for you and you can load it from this code block here. This data can now be used to evaluate the model. Now let us see the different models depending on the different data set sizes. So we initially ran this model on the entire size of our data set, which is 3.6 million and 0.4 million for the test set. Since the size was of this data set was too large, we could run it just for one epoch and it showed a promising accuracy of 89.77%. On a smaller data set size of 0.6 million, we ran it over 5 epochs and it showed the accuracy of 91.9%. And on the current data set size of 1 million on 5 epochs, it showed 92.32%. This shows that HAN has a lot of room to improve given a large data set size and more epochs. Now I will continue to compare the different models in terms of time. So as we can see from these graphs, RNN took the most time to train, followed by HAN and then closely followed by CNN. So after conducting this project, these are the conclusions that we came to. CNN showed the highest training and validation accuracies followed by HAN and RNN. HAN model seemed promising and has a good accuracy at the end of 5 epochs. And while CNN and RNN accuracies had almost gone flat by the end. Now when the training dataset size is small, CNN seems to perform well as opposed to HAN that performs well on large dataset. So what we can conclude is that for HAN to perform well, you need large dataset sizes and a good run of a large number of epochs, while CNN produces a decent model given less training time and a smaller dataset size. So the future scope, some of the ways we could improve our model is by increasing the data set size or the number of epochs. The other ways we could tune the hyperparameters of the different models, that is the learning rate, the batch size, number of epochs, is by using manual search, grid search, random search, and other cross-validation techniques. Additional steps could involve pre-processing steps such as removal of punctuation, stemming, eliminating less frequent words. Thank you.